who's Sarah Hildebrandt at the Olympic Museum here in Colorado Springs. First time Olympian, but also we're the first team in here, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like the women and men wrestlers from the United States are the first Olympic team to tour the Olympic Museum. What was that like for you to go through here and know that you're part of this family?
Oh my gosh, it's like emotional. It was really cool, really special. I was so excited to come here today, but it was even cooler than I imagined. So, you know, and it's obviously just incredibly special now being an Olympian, getting to go through this with, you know, my fellow teammates and stuff like that. So, how cool. I stress everybody to come here. It's incredibly inspiring, and hopefully I can come back before we go to games because it's really fired me up.
So how you been doing? What have you done since trials? What's it been like? Two things. What'd you do when it was over? And B, what's it been like having people come up and say, hi, Olympian?
I don't think I've gotten used to that part. Afterwards, just kind of tried to focus on coming down a little. You know, you're on such a high, and you've trained so hard preparing up for trials, you know, I did. And so just kind of coming down a little and getting ready for the preparation into games. But no, it's been so cool, and I've just felt such an overwhelming, endless amount of support from people all over the place. I'm so grateful for that. It's been so, so amazing, more than I could ever imagine. So that's been fun, just getting to, you know, I just feel so loved and supported, and it's a really awesome thing.
Talk about what you're looking to do this week in training. First training camp, not the last. You guys have a long preparation period leading up to Tokyo, but what kind of things are you and the coaches working on?
Yeah, you know, right now we're just kind of really getting in. For me, I'm just kind of, you know, zeroing in on some certain areas with opponents. It's nice now that I don't have to focus domestically anymore. I can just focus on international opponents. So, you know, we've started breaking down some film and kind of transferring that over into the practice room and looking at things like that. But really, I'm just trying to feel good, get out there, move. There's a lot of logistical stuff on the outside, talking with my coaches about specific things I want, what I'm looking for going into preparation, what I'm looking for going into competition. So kind of just getting on the same wavelength as everybody, and then going from there.
So let's talk a little bit about how you feel your competition went for trials, what kind of things it will take for you to go from Olympian to Olympic champ.
Yeah, I really felt great at trials. I felt honestly the best I've ever felt. And I had a blast. It was so much fun, and I think just finding that balance between, like, I'm going to rip your head off and calm. I think that's where I operate the best, and I did a good job of that at trials. I don't think I have to, you know, at first I was thinking, like, oh my gosh, going to Olympic team camp, you're the Olympian, like, I almost felt like I had to be more, but I think that's a mistake. Like, I think I'm enough right now. I think that there's not necessarily huge changes that need to happen to go from Olympic qualifier to Olympic champion, and I think right now I have the skill, talent, and ability to be an Olympic champion tomorrow if I stepped on the mat. But what can I do to keep, you know, healthy up here, keep my body healthy, make, you know, corrections, adjustments, be aware of things for a match, have a smart gameplay going out there. And I think those are the answers to being an Olympic champion come August.
So what'd you learn in the last year after they pushed it back a year? Because you were ready last year, right?
Yeah.
What kind of things have going on in your life that you're bringing forward to Tokyo?
Yeah, like I said, I think kind of finding that balance between, like, all the adrenaline and also just being really calm. I think the biggest gains I made over the last year were just what's going on in my mind. And they're really, really valuable, you know. I feel like I've made so many gains there that it's almost hard to articulate. Like, I've felt such a mental shift in the last year that's come from just actually having to step away from the mat and being away, my whole training being uprooted and different. You know, it really forces you to make a different approach. And I think that those changes have actually been so, so much better for me. And so I think going into the games now in 2021 than I would have maybe in 2020, I'm a much better athlete, person, and just even more prepared than I would have been.
Well, anything that you want to say to the folks back in Indiana?
Oh,
I know you haven't
goodness.
Had as much a chance to get there as you might
like. Yeah, I know. First of all, I want to get back there so badly, but more importantly, I cannot even begin to express my gratitude for the whole state. It's like so much support throughout my whole career, not even just, you know, in the last few weeks, but my whole career has just been amazing, supportive people. You know, that's my hometown, so I'm always just so much love for it and all the people there. So I can't wait to bring home this medal for them. So let's go.
Awesome. Thanks a lot, Sarah.
Yeah.
Be good.